What stocks did investors buy and sell in May? TD Ameritrade is out with some fresh data. Here now is the company's chief market strategist, JJ Kinahan. So JJ, your clients bought Apple, Facebook, and Amazon in May. No surprise.
No surprise. It's been a continuing trend. Very interesting that the retail trader has been a net buyer 4 months in a row. The move in the market, as you talk to people every day, is this market that gets no respect. And yet it continues higher and higher, and the retail trader's been a believer.
Well, and Amazon recently closed above $1,000 a share, and it's amazing. These companies want that to happen. It's like a badge of honor.
Yeah, it really is kind of amazing. You know, it's like the 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 levels in the Dow. In reality, well, it means something, because if you're long the stock, hopefully it went well for you. But in the grand scheme, it doesn't necessarily, the round number, mean anything in terms of a technical level, but it is kind of a big deal for them, and you know, that's amazing.
Well, we used to see these companies want to split the stock when it got that high, but now they want the publicity of it getting to $1,000 a share.
It really is. The one thing that is, the only bad part I'll say about that is, if you think about the amount of money it costs for a retail trader to buy those types of companies, it's can be tough, but it is one of the reasons that options have been so widely used by retail traders, because they can express the same opinion, define their risk, and not have to put up so much money in order to just buy 100 shares. So it's really become a great way for retail traders to manage their capital. And one of the things professionals don't think about is how to manage capital always, because they have quite a bit of it usually.
Right. Well, and even with the capital appreciation we've been seeing in stocks over the past couple of months, you also had a lot of investors with a yield play, Ford, AT&T, and Verizon.
Absolutely right. You're talking about three stocks there that are paying right around a 5% yield. Many people may question the Ford one, but as we saw, you know, with them naming the CEO, the stock had a little bit of a pop. It's still a very affordable stock. And as you and I are talking, I don't think if you would have asked either of us in January if we'd be talking about a 10-year rate less than 2.2%,
right,
we'd have said, you're crazy. There's no way. So as we have this low yield on bonds, you're looking for stocks, and those three stocks share one thing in common. They've all been beaten up a little bit recently, started on their way back, and our clients, when they were getting beaten up, came in and said, this seems like a good yield play and a chance for the stock to bounce back with the rest of the market.
Yeah, and talking about stocks that have been beaten up, on the sell side, we've got Whole Foods and Arconic. Obviously, a lot of negative press around these two names, yes, with some activist investor pressure.
Yeah, that's exactly it. You had Whole Foods getting some downgrades during the month also. And Arconic, you know, that's a stock that it's under $5 now, so that can be a little bit of a tougher spot for a stock to be in, let's say that.
All right, JJ Kinahan, we'll leave it there. Thanks so much for coming back with us.
Always a pleasure. Thank you, Scott.
All right, I'm Scott Gamm, and you're watching The Street.